Hello, I'm Ron Powers, Associate Director of the Cooperative Extension Service and Program Leader for the Community Resource Development and Public Affairs Program at Iowa State University. I'm pleased to have the opportunity to share a few comments with you about the situation that you as a community leader are facing in determining the destiny of your community with respect to achieving economic development and providing the facilities and services which are demanded by the citizens in your community. The challenges to each of you will be substantial as you go about trying to resolve those problems. Economic development, of course, refers to the provision of new jobs and increasing incomes of those who are already employed. Facilities and services cuts across a wide array of activities, but they include things related to health, safety, parks, roads, utilities, community centers, and the like. Some of the services are provided through public taxation. Some are provided privately. As we look ahead, we're going to need to find new ways to organize, to finance, and to deliver services at the community level. That same spirit of looking for new ways to develop jobs at the local level will also be needed by those who work and give leadership to communities. Now, there's some key trends that have been taking place in the last several years that are going to impact on your community, particularly as it relates to facilities and services, and I'd like to note just a few of those for you. In Iowa, for example, 60% of the communities have actually declined in population during the last 6 years. When we look at enrollment in schools, K through 12, there's been a 49% decrease in the enrollment in the 70 most rural counties in the last period since 1970. In addition to that, we're all aware that the federal support for rural development has decreased since 1980. Almost two-thirds less money is available for grants to rural areas, and almost 41% less money is available in the form of loan guarantees for projects in rural areas. And everyone is painfully aware of the decrease in land values in this state, which have averaged almost two-thirds since 1981. In addition to that, we know that the infrastructure that's already in place, roads, bridges, sewer and water systems, and a number of others are aging and are going to require replacement or fixing up in the next years ahead. Indeed, I would say to you that the next crisis in rural areas in this state and much of the Midwest is in the area of facilities and services. Iowa will not escape that crisis. The solutions to community facilities and services problems in your communities will be difficult. They will also be costly, no matter what options you choose. The solutions are going to demand change in the way we go about providing those, and they're going to vary from community to community. And most important, solutions are going to demand informed and capable leadership at the local level. Some people have said if we would just have a more profitable agriculture, or if we'd have economic development in the form of new jobs, that those issues would disappear. But I tell you, the hard facts are the issue related to providing community facilities and services will not go away. Those communities that have prided themselves on being independent and solving their own problems are going to find that that's a very costly option. They will also most certainly find that both the quality and the quantity of facilities and services will decrease, except in those places where economic growth is occurring. The per capita cost will go up, and many people may not be willing or able to pay the cost. And federal and state governments are increasingly showing an unwillingness to invest tax dollars in infrastructure or facilities and services in communities that are not going to grow economically. Those communities whose citizens, leaders decide that there are other alternatives to pursue will have to do three things: learn, learn, and learn. They're going to have to learn the facts, they're going to have to learn the alternatives, and they're going to have to learn how to involve people in the community to make the projects and the changes workable so that they will be involved in supporting the changes necessary. In the final analysis, we're talking about leadership, and that's built on knowledge and understanding. Knowledge and understanding which can mobilize resources at the local level. And those resources are more than money. They're new ideas. Their willingness to consider the unthinkable, such as cutting across county lines or community lines or across different services. Their willingness to think about creating perhaps a neighborhood of communities that will work together as one unit to provide goods and services to their communities and also to develop jobs for the total area. We're pleased that you're willing to begin this exploration process. Extension should be a valuable resource to you and is available through your county or area office. There are other sources available to help you in the state as well, and we'd be pleased to refer you to them as you may have need for them. We join with you in the process that you're undertaking in this program. We are both going to be teachers and learners, and we have much to teach and learn from each other. The important thing to keep in mind is that together we can take charge of our future.